Mug South.
What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things on the Mod Sauce server. I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. So today we're wearing our hard hat. Why? Because we built something. Do you guys smell that? Do you guys hear something? I think there's a speedy up bit coming. Check it out, peeps. Tech HQ. It's a thing. You have it, guys. We're gonna call this building the Tech HQ, and I hope you guys liked the montage. If you did, make sure you leave a thumbs up and let me know. So it's a thing, and I got some Slipgatory symbols on it. Now, we don't really have ways up or down yet. It's just a shell, and right now it is a little plain. There's gonna be a lot of detail we're gonna add to it. So there's a couple of different plans I want to have explained to you, kind of how it's gonna go. So we're gonna add some detail to the outside, most likely using some cover strips or something like that. I gotta figure out what I want to do, and we're gonna do an entrance too. So I'm going to go ahead and build that maybe a little bit later off camera or something like that. I'll show you how it goes. So we've still got all of our stuff and things going on down here. We'll have to get stuff moved around. So that's going to be kind of what we're doing. In addition to that, upstairs here in the top bits, what's going to end up going on here is that we're going to have a lot of different machines, and I'm going to do a lot of exposed wiring. And the reason that I think that that'll be good, see, the way that I like to build it, let me give you like a little, for people who have trouble building. Some people are great builders. If you're a great builder, just cover your ears. If sometimes you struggle with different things, you know, one of the reasons why I went really plain, this clear glass is really plain. I went really plain blocks. And I picked these blocks because they're easy to get this early stage of the game. And I wanted the textures to be really, really plain and flat. Because on the inside, what we're going to do is put all sorts of machines, and we're going to put all sorts of exposed wiring inside of here. So when you get into that exposed wiring, do I have any wire? Sorry, I have like 9 pieces of wire here. So let me see if I can like display it kind of sort of what will happen. So when you get like exposed wiring back here and then you put it in like that, and then you have all sorts of tech and machines, it adds little bits of detail. And that starts to make things look, you know, detailed. That's how we're going to get our detail, by having that sort of stuff and things, that exposed wiring detail in the build. So I think it's going to be pretty rad. So we used about half a diamond chest of clear glass, and almost an entire diamond chest full of the the smooth stone in order to make this bad boy happen. So there's a lot of blocks here, man. And in case you guys are wondering, I also really quickly had made up. Oh yeah, I made a tape measure or tape measure if you're from Pennsylvania. And the tape measure is really easy to make. Super simple. It's a 4-iron with a tape measure reel and that system string and a dandelion. And what this lets you do is measure the size of stuff and things. So I think this guy is 25. 25 by 64 is how big it is. And then, yeah. So I think it's cool. I think it's pretty fun. But, you know, we're going to do something else today that is going to be pretty fun. We're going to start to get into applied energistics. So let me see here. There we go. Bam. So the first thing we got to build is this meteorite compass because we've got to go on the hunt for meteorites. So we need 4 of these guys. And I haven't done a ton of research on it. I asked DMAC and I asked, oh, did I get one? Just the one? Oof, man, perfect aim. So I asked DMAC and who's the other guy? Zul'jin. A little bit about what to do. Just kind of getting an idea. And I've watched a couple of videos on it a long time ago when it was still kind of really in its earliest infant stages. And I got really sad. Oh, look at that thing. So I got really sad about it. AE's one of my favorite mods of all time. I love the fact that you just make it work. It's you need to grind out some resources. You get your resources and you're good to go. It was one of the only mods that worked. It worked almost every time. It was versatile. It was easy. And it was powerful. And I felt like it was great offset to some of the other mods that are a bit more grindy. And sort of that way. So I know over here, oh man. Oh, it's like, so how come when I go back here, it points to one. And then right here, it starts to, is it floating? Oh, it stopped. It's not floating now. All right, it's better. So I know that in this area, a lot of people have already harvested the meteorites. And then over here, I do believe this is Azuma's base. And I never realized that we were that close. I don't know how that really happened. I'm kind of blown away, actually. But yeah, X is like my next door neighbor. So we're going to head over in this direction. We're going to do some searching for the meteorite. When I find one, I'll bring you guys back. I'll be our bees.
Mod South.
And we're back. And I got to tell you guys, this is one of the coolest world gen things I've seen. Like, it's like a world gen triple threat. One of the coolest things I've seen in a long time. So this is where like a Thaumcraft tree used to be. And all we got now is like cheaty snow hanging out here. You could really do something cool with that. I don't know, maybe, but probably not. But anyway, then you have the, I can't remember what this biome is called. Yeah, Twilight Glacier with all these penguins hanging out. There's 2 meteorites right here. And then over here, oh yeah, it's squirreling around. Then over here, there was another thing. And I don't know if this is like a boss or what this is. And I've never seen this before. So we're actually going to discover, we're going to go adventuring and see what this is together. Together. Oh, man, I've never seen this. What are you guys? Yeti? This is crazy, man. Are they going to, like, attack? Are you guys peeved off? No? Oh, yeah. Oh, crap. You're peeved off. A little bit of lag there. Oh, man. Oh, what the hell? What is going on? I don't know what that was. We got Arctic fur. All right. We got to do this, man. AE can wait. What do we get? More Arctic? Oh, man. What's going on? Oh, man. It's like a Yeti boss thing. Let's do it, guys. I wonder if we could do it with our crappy armor and all of our crappy stuff and things. Yeah, take that, bat. Oh, man. I feel like there's some lag going on. Oh, he grabbed me. Do you see that? He, like, had me in his clutches. I was clutched. Oh, he dropped ice? Whoa. That guy's throwing stuff at me. I gotta get some food in me. Which one of these swords does more damage, real quick? +6, +7. All right. Let's do this Alpha Yeti. Oh, man, he, like, takes out blocks. Oh, wow, he's got 200 health. Holy crap, he's freaking out, man. Get pissed. I'm getting him. 80, 68, 56. I know I could use 2 swords. Stop commenting. I got him. Oh, wow. Like, there's like falling ice and stuff. What did he drop? Ice bombs? Alpha Yeti fur? What can he do with this stuff? Oh, man. Yeah, the Yeti jacket. You can make armor with it. Crazy. Oh, Yeti horned helm. I got to make one. That thing looks awesome. So, oh, did you see that bat with the catfish on his head? Oh, my God. So this is a totally cool new structure. I'm guessing is straight from the Twilight that I had not seen before. What is that little bat got on his head? What do you got going on, bat? No, I want your hat, homie. Give it to me, the hat. Flowers in a hat, man. Let's do it. Bam. I look so adorable. All right. So we can definitely take a look for more of the Yeti stuff and things. But now we're up over in here. We got to start focusing, man. What is this? Wool of the bat. I didn't know you could get bat wool. Alright, so many cool things, so many shiny things. I like it. It's super cool. Alright, so let's go over here, check out this meteorite, see what's going on with it. Is this another wolf? Man, he's got a squirter. Alright, so we got our meteorite now. Supposedly, inside of here, there's a chest, I guess. So we're going to try to dig down inside. That's what I keep hearing. And, man, it's freaking out. Oh, what's this block? Skystone. Oh, that's the chest right there. All right, so we got Skystone out of this. Inscriber Engineer Press. Inscriber Calculation Press. Let's go ahead and grab our hammer and just start hammering this bad boy out. And this might be some good blocks to go ahead and collect as well. I don't know if there's more than one chest. I'm going to take a wild guess and say that there's a single chest in each one. So we found two here. Getting a little bit of lag. Still getting a little bit of lag. All right. So we got two here. We got another meteorite right over there. Oh my God. I don't know what that is either. What is it? Is that another meteorite too? I think there's three. That's crazy. All right. I got a ton of harvesting to do. We're going to go and check that out in a second here, but for now, I'm going to go ahead and start clearing out this. I want to collect a lot of these Skystone blocks just to have. And yeah, I'm going to make a little progress, and I'll be RBs.
Mod South.
All right, and we're back, and I didn't find a chest over in this little, like, half meteorite, but there's one over here, and there's one over there. I found two chests, and I got the Silicon Press, Logic Press, Calculation Press, and Engineering Press, and I think that those are all of the presses. I think, let's go ahead and just search for press. Oh, man. That ain't gonna work. So, at mod.applied energistics 2. So, just taking a look here real quick. Oh, that's Inscriber Name Press. Oh, that might be one we have to make. See, I just don't know anything about it. So, we'll figure it out. But we got four of these guys from this spot over here. I'm actually going to go ahead and make a waypoint here. Meteors, baby. Babu. All right, so we'll get Meteors, baby going on. And that way we can come back here if we absolutely need Skystone. I don't think we need it for anything, actually. Let's take a look at the uses on that. So you can make the Skystone chest, which I have a couple of. Skystone dust. Oh, that looks like a cool block. All right, so there's definitely some cool building blocks we might want to come back for. Now, let's go ahead and check this bad boy out. I have not seen one of these before, and it is absolutely amazing looking. I love the look of this thing. This is the, what are these blocks? Oh, the Aurora blocks? Man, oh man, what is going on up here? Look at the world gen, man. That's crazy. What do you got on your head, homie? Mine. I'm different. So, looks like there's a couple weird things going on in here. What do you got? A couple safari nets? Let's take those, baby. Saddle? I think we'll take the saddle just in case. I don't remember if Trail Mix is in this mod pack or not. I can't remember if we had that added in. I would love it if it was, but I don't think. No Trail Mix. All right, so we may not need that, but these Aurora blocks look amazing. Oh, it looks like somebody may have already found this area. Yeah, somebody's already been in here, man. So Top Mass has been here. I don't know. Top Master Jevin, those are the guys that are like hyper explorers. But it looks like somebody's been in this area already. Oh, man. This Aurora stuff is amazing. So cool. We're getting into the bad guys situation here. Oh, man. These guys are tough. You know, for now, let's just do one of these. Probably be easier. So get both swords, man. Two sword action. I don't know if that worked any better or not. Oh, what do we got going on? Oh, what are you? Oh, oh. Go, go. Eat, homie. Eat. Oh, what? Oh, man. Oh, does Matt? No, no. What? You're kidding me. You're kidding me.
Mod South.
All right. I went back and grabbed some emergency armor, a pick and a sword, a little bit of food. Let's head in here. I'm really going to be like extremely sad panda if my items aren't here, because I don't even know what I'm going to do if that's the case. I'm just going to fly up to the top, I think, and then I'm just going to dig. All right. So it was right in here. This might be actually an explosion from me. Man, this stuff's hard to mine, huh? Is my stuff here? Or is it... Is this me? Oh, man, I'm stuck. Just says gravestone. Oh, man. Let's put this in here. Let's just go like this. Actually, let's block this up right like that. Oh, man, that is my stuff. Oh, crap. It's a bunch of other crap, too. Is my bag in here? All right, sweet. Bag of holding. Let's put all this stuff in here. Oh, man. What is all this extra crap? I need my ring of suck. Throw these books away. Is that it? Is that all my stuff, man? Oh, my God. I can't believe we got it all back. I thought that was going to be like a major, massive problem. So, looks like we got all of our tools. Yeah, I feel like we're good. I feel like we're good to go. That was a little bit scary, though, I'll be honest with you. Maybe you got to start taking precautions in the future so that, eventually we'll have some better armor and it won't matter anymore. So, I think that's going to be in our future. I know DMAC has made some new armor that's really amazing. Did I get more? What did I just get? Oh, because I put my suck coin back on. I got some paper or something. But D-Max just got in. How do I get out? Let me out of here, danger, death zone, trap, place of death. D-Max got some new armor that's really baller, and I know Z's got some stuff and things going on too. So, all right, I feel like we got our press things that we needed. We're good to go with that. So I think it's time to maybe head back to the tech HQ and start getting stuff and things done.
Mod South.
All right, guys, so I went back to the ghetto area, and I made a sag mill real quick using Ender IO stuff and things, and I'm grinding up some nether quartz and another quartz dust. We're going to need that to make some silicon, I think. But this is something, all right, this is a thing, this is a real thing. This is a real, look at me, this is a real part of the mod. We're going to do this, it's a real part of this mod. All right, look, so we're going to make this Flux crystal. In order to make this, we need to drop a charged Certus quartz. One charged Certus quartz. Let's go back and read this again. One charged Certus quartz, one nether quartz, and one redstone dust into a puddle next to one another, and wait a moment. That's a real thing. So, all right, let's take off our ring of suck. This is like a real thing that's happening. One of these, one of these, one of these. This is what we got to do, for real. All right, that's in there. This is a puddle, I guess. It did it! Did it? Is that it? It made it! What a silly mechanic. That is the silliest mechanic I've ever seen, man. That's for reals how it's done. All right, I already made two sticky pistons. I just can't believe that's an actual thing. Stick them in a puddle. That's the new thing. Put things in a puddle. I'm assuming you could have made a recipe for like a machine besides stick them in a puddle, But I don't know. Again, whatever. All right. So we got our inscriber. Now, this is going to allow us to, like, make stuff. So we need to power this bad boy, which I got to think. I got to think about. I'm just too tickled about the stupid put it in a puddle. So isn't there a handle? I think I can put a handle on this bad boy. What is that thing called again? Let's look it up. Wooden crank. So we just need some sticks. All right, so let's grab some sticks down here real quick. I got a whole stack of sticks right there. And let's make this crank, because I think you can crank this bad boy, if I'm not mistaken. So let's see if we can. I'm not sure. I heard tell. Okay, you can't crank it. There is something that you can crank. Oh, right here, this charger. All right, so we need to make another. We need to squirt more things in the puddle to make this charger. Let's see if we can get that. Because this is, I mean, I think I could power it more advanced, you know, in a more advanced way straight away. But I do want to play around with this. So what was it again? Oh, yeah. Charge thingies. Squirt one of those in the puddle. Redstone in the puddle. Squirt out redstone. And nether quartz. Wait a moment. And it did it. Made a thing from the puddle. All right. So, wait. What do we want to do again? This charger is what I want to play with. So I just want to see how it works. So we get this charger. Squirt it like that. Make one of those guys. Now, I think we could put this on the back of our inscriber. Maybe just adjacent to? I don't know. I don't know if you have to wire it up or not. We should be able to put a handle crank thingy-doodler on there. And then if we go squirt like this, does that give us juice? I don't know. I don't know if it gives us juice. There's no interface for this thing. Let's see if it gives juice. All right, so let's look up silicon, because that's what we want. One of the base things that we got to make here. So you need the inscribed silicon press, put silicon in there to get that. All right, so how do we make the regular straight up silicon? I thought it was just with the dust. Wait. This is the silicon we want to make. Yes, it is just smelting the dust. That's why we made the dust. So let's go ahead and head down here. If we squirt these guys into our alloy smelter, is that going to make us the silicon that we want? Let's see. We'll squirt it double in, because I'm pretty sure it is. Is it going to take forever and a day? Nah, it's not. It's going pretty quick. Are we going to see the animation? All right, so we did get some silicon. All right, cool. So we got some silicon now. We got more automatically getting made down there. So now what we wanted to do, we wanted to make the printed silicon. So we need, again, inscriber silicon press. Bam. Piece of silicon. Bam. Can we charge you, bad boy thing, dude, like this? Are you, like, halfway done? No. All right. So let's try maybe, where did it go? Oh, come back here. What if we squirt you right on top? Become a thing. All right. Are you now charging this bad boy? Oh. I'm just guessing here to see if this works. I just want to see. I don't think it does, though. Yeah, it doesn't seem to be doing anything. We got this right. Inscriber, silicone press, inscriber. All right, so charger thingy, I'm not using it right, or I got to wire it up at the very least. And I think I'm going to take a moment now and just do a little bit of research, make sure I get this going the right way, or a better way at the very least, get my inscriber online. I'll be RBs.
Mod South.
Why didn't you guys tell me I was being silly? So the charger, what you do is you squirt a piece of Surtis quartz in there, just regular old Surtis quartz, and then you hand crank it, and you can power this thing too. Either way, and then after a minute, you'll see the texture will change on the Surtis quartz crystal. Bam! Makes a little animation, and you get charged Surtis quartz. So that's one of the ways you can make charged Surtis quartz. All right, so on our inscriber here, you can see we got a little bit of a job done, but not all the way of a job done. We got an energy cell right here, and this is basically Applied Energistics energy storage cell. And then we got this block called the energy acceptor. Now, energy acceptor, what does that guy look like? Where are you? Right here. Energy acceptor is made with some quartz glass, some iron, and either flux crystal or the pure flux crystal. And all you can do with this guy, or what you can do with this guy, is just plop down any sort of power generation right next to it, and it's going to go ahead and start to power this bad boy, and that's giving us these printed silicon. So we're good to go there. So the other piece, or one of the first pieces we're going to want to start making, is our ME terminal. So that means we need a logic processor. So we need some redstone, printed silicon, and a printed logic circuit. So the logic press needs to be in here. So we take this press out, put our logic press in. How did it go?
Oh, man.
Gold. All right, so we got some gold over here. Let's go ahead and just grab, can we just make like 32 of these bad boys? Squirt some gold in there. Automatically starts working. Bam, we're making stuff and things. So you can't put more than one in at a time. That's perfect. Do they stack on the output at least? So they do stack on the output. Oh, man. So I've heard that the mod author made this so it was less like automated, and there's a lot more babysitting going on, which is really disappointing. It's too bad that that's the case. No one likes to babysit their machines. That's the case here with the inscriber. So you got to do this manually. Yay! So we're going to get a few of these guys going, and then we need the... this silicon redstone. All right, so we need some redstone. Do I have any dust? I have some right on me. All right, cool. So let's pull this guy out of here. Let's go ahead and stick... Can we stick a stack in there? No, we can only do one at a time. Yep, perfect. So so then we're going to go like this, and then this is going to make us our thingy. Logic processor stage one thing. All right, sweet. So now we've got to make a dark or a light illuminated panel. So it looks like some glowstone, quartz glass, redstone, and iron. All right, so I think I have glowstone down here. I believe the mining dimension gives us glowstone. Yeah, I got some right here. All right, so let's just go down this crafting table. Let's go ahead and take a look at this illuminated panel again. And so like this, bam, we get three of these bad boys. All right, so that's the illuminated panel. The next piece are these annihilation cores. So those take logic processors, Fluix dust, and then we can use nether quartz or whatever. So the Fluix dust, do I have any? I don't. So in order to make more Fluix crystals, we need charge crystals like this. So we got to go like this and make some more of these bad boys in a puddle. All right. So now we got some more of those guys. And then we come over to our SAG mill. Go ahead and squirt these guys in. And then they're 1-to-1. So we're only going to get one for each one. And so we only need two. So we should be good to go with this with two. All right, two Fluix dust, and then let's take a look here. Annihilation core. We get two of those out of that guy. All right, so we're good to go with that. And then, is that a thing? No, wait, why is it not a thing? Oh, I think I need another logic processor. That's what's going on. So go back up in here, squirt. Oh, it just puts three and one in each one. All right, so that doesn't work. And then, bam, we'll make one more logic processor. Inventory's getting nice and clogged up. All right, bam. Now can we make a thing? Bam. What? We got our thing. Dark or illuminated panel. Logic processor, illuminated panel, two annihilation. Oh, these are formation cores. What? I need the annihilation core. Did I make that wrong? I guess I did. All right. So we got more dust down here, right? We got a couple more. All right. Let's see if maybe I auto... What? No. That can't have... I couldn't have accidentally done the wrong thing. Annihilation core. Formation core. Annihilation core. We got it. What? I have to watch back the video and see what I did. That was what I did stupidly. Formation core. Am I, what, logic processor? Oh, one uses the nether stuff, one uses surge quartz. All right, so I must have clicked the wrong one. All right, so now, no. We got our annihilation cores, we got our illuminated panel. Oh, we don't have our logic thing. Man, oh man. All right, one more time. I'm really confident. This is going to be the thing. We're going to be able to actually get something done. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be the best thing ever. Logic processor. Feel like we're really excited. Boom! ME terminal, baby! Now we can see stuff. Plop it on there. Whoa, that was bad. What? What happened? Oh, I broke it. It goes like the wrong way. Whoops. All right, so what about light panels? What if you shift click them on? They just face in. That's so weird. All right, so anyway, we got our terminal going on. I wanted to squirt it on here so I could see what it looked like. You know what? Maybe if I wrench that guy, it will squirt around. Nope. I'm in there, though. No, it just pops off. All right, so at least we can kind of see what stuff and things are going to look like. Once we have a storage area, we've got some extra spots here I've not seen before. I guess these maybe are for storage drives straight away. You get to stick them in the terminal? I don't know. That might be a thing. All right, so a little bit more research, and I'll be your bees.
Mod South.
So that's going to be it for today, guys. That's all the time we have. I think that we're going to be doing more of the grindy AE2 stuff off cam and maybe get the front part of the new Tech HQ built. But I had a really good time, and we finally got into doing some building, so I'm so excited. I can't wait to fill it up with technology stuff and things. Next, we're going to start getting in Batania, Witchery, Blood Magic, or the other mods, but Batania is going to be next. I'm really psyched about it. So yeah, if you liked the video, please don't forget to hit the like button. Feel free to share and favorite it as you see fit. Don't spam it on Reddit, peeps. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day.